लेट अस रिवाइज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वॉट एवर वी हैव डन इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर. फर्स्ट फॉर्मूलाज ऑफ सिंपल इंटरेस्ट. फर्स्ट फॉर्मूला सिंपल इंटरेस्ट इक्वल टू पी आई एन, दैट इज द फर्स्ट फॉर्मूला. सेकेंड फॉर्मूला टोटल अमाउंट इक्वल टू प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट प्लस सिंपल इंटरेस्ट, दैट इज total amount equal to p plus pin, and you can take p common, so we get like this. And third formula, on the basis of this you can find out I. Very simple, a upon p minus 1 upon n, or n equal to a upon p minus 1 upon I. So these are the only four formulas in simple interest. Now compound interest. First formula for compound interest is, here we get direct total amount, a equal to p in bracket 1 plus I raised to n. I is nothing but what? R upon 100. And from this total amount, if we subtract our principal amount, then whatever we get, that is nothing but our interest. Here it is known as compound interest. So compound interest is nothing but a minus p. If we put a equal to p in bracket 1 plus I raised to n, and if we keep this minus p as it is, after taking p common, we get another formula of compound interest. For first year, we know that compound interest and simple interest are same. For first 2 years, we know the formula for difference of compound interest and simple interest. The formula is very simple, pi square. For first 3 years, difference in compound interest and simple interest is pi square in bracket I plus 3. And we know that if interest is calculated half yearly or quarterly or monthly, then there is no change in the formula of simple interest. The reason is, in simple interest we get interest on principal amount only, whereas in compound interest we get interest on interest also. So if in the question it is mentioned that interest is calculated half yearly or quarterly or monthly, in that case we have to make the effect in the formula. Reason is, if interest is calculated quarterly, that means every 3 months interest will be added in our principal amount or in our total amount. So every time we get more interest, every quarter we get more interest compared to previous quarter, because we get interest on interest also. So in that case, we have to make slight change in our formula. So for quarterly interest, sorry, let us start with semi-annually. If interest is calculated half yearly, or you can say that semi-annually, that means you will get interest every 6 months, then what is the change in the formula? Divide I by 2, because your rate of interest becomes half, like 8% per annum. 8% per annum, if you get interest calculated half yearly, means you will get 4% 2 times. So you have to divide our 8% divide 8% by 2, that means 4%. So divide I by 2 and multiply number of years by 2, means n by 2. So if there are 3 years, then we get interest 6 times. Why 6 times? Every 6 months we get interest. Similarly, for quarterly, we have to divide I by 4 and we have to multiply n by 4. And for monthly, we have to divide I by 12 and n by 12. We have to multiply n by 12. So this is the effect we require to make in our formula if interest is calculated quarterly, half yearly or monthly. Okay. One another formula, let us discuss that formula, which is related to depreciation. See, this is the formula of appreciation. This is the formula of appreciation. That means whatever we invest at present, that is nothing but P. After the end of some number of years, our amount will increase. How much? That depends on N and I. But this is the formula of appreciation because our amount will increase. Similarly, there is a formula of depreciation. What is depreciation? If we purchase something, let us say any machine, so C is the cost of the machine. That is nothing but our investment in the machine. But our value of the machine will reduce if number of years will increase. That is known as what? Depreciation. So instead of plus I, here you would write minus I. And instead of P, that is present principal amount, instead of that you have to write our cost of the machine. And what is S? Any of you know what is S? Stand for year? What is S here? S is known as scrap value. S is known as scrap value. Means the value of the machine at the end of certain number of years, because every year it will reduce according to some fix or a very changes rate of depreciation. Okay, now let us start examples depends on this, then we will continue with another part of this topic, that is annuity. So let us start examples. Question number one. The question. First, simple interest SI, that means simple interest on 3500 for 3 years at 12% per annum is. So out of these four, which one is the correct answer? That is the question. So it is a very simple question. Simple interest on 3500 for 3 years at 12%. So what you require to do? Just simply multiply this 3. So simple interest, we know the formula PIN. What is our amount here? 3500. What is rate of interest? 12%. And here number of years? 3. Simple calculation is there and you will get the answer. Calculate and tell me the answer. One, two, six, zero. That is the final answer. So this is simple question. Answer for this question is 1260. Question number two, almost same like this. P is given, R, rate of interest 15%, but because it's R, it is only 15. And T, that means time, here N, it is 4.5 years. And it is given that use the formula I equal to PRN upon 100. Instead of R, it is T only. And you would require to calculate I. So I means simple interest only. Same formula you can use. Here P is 5000. I is nothing but R upon 100. Our R is 15. So 15 divided by 100 is 0.15. And n means time, 4.5 years, so 4.5. Now simple calculation, 5000 into 0.15 into 4.5, 3375. That is the answer. Question number 3. If p t I is given, you require to calculate r. Once again, it's simple. Use the formula. Here, I is given, interest is given 300, P is given 5000. I is unknown, and time is 1 year. So, obviously, I is nothing but what? 300 divided by 5000. 0.06. That means 6%. That is the answer. So it is simple question. Question number 4. P is given, A is given, and you require simple interest. So it's very simple. When P and A both are given, difference of that is the answer. So 7000 is the total amount, and principal amount is 4500. So the answer is 2500. That is the interest. So it's very simple. Question number 5. P is given, A is given, T is given, and rate percentage per annum we require to calculate. So you require to use the formula. Here you require to calculate n, and we have formula a upon p minus 1 upon I. This is a formula to find out n when a and p are given in simple interest. Now here a is 16,500 divided by 12,000. 16,500 divided by 12,000 minus 1 divided by rate of interest. Sorry, here n is given and we have to find out I. So we have to use this formula. I equal to a upon b minus 1 upon n. N means nothing but time. Here it is 2.5. So once again, simple calculation is required. 16,500 divided by 12,000 minus 1 divided by 2.5. So answer is 0.15. That means 15%. If you have any question, you can ask your doubt immediately. Whenever you have problem, you are free to ask your doubt. Question number 6. P is given, I is given, R is given, but you require to calculate N, number of years. Now you it is possible to use this formula after calculating A, because here P and I is given. So just by adding this two number, we get A. But instead of that, you can use this formula also. Simple interest equal to P I N. I, that is nothing but rate of interest 12.5%. So it is 0.125, and n is unknown. N means time that we have to calculate. So If you calculate this, you will get 1250 n. So what is n? 2500 divided by 1250. That is nothing but 2. So number of years, 2. That is the answer. Because A is not available, that is nothing but what? P plus simple interest. P is what? 10,000. A, and you can use the formula N equal to A upon P minus 1 upon I. So 12,500 divided by 10,000 minus 1 upon I. That is 0.125. You can do the calculation. That is also possible. 12,500 minus 10,000 minus 1. Sorry, 12,500 divided by 10,000. Once again, 12,500 divided by 10,000 minus 1 divided by 0.125. So we get 2. So number of years, 2. That is our final answer. Question number 7. P is given, A is given, R is given, and you have to find out interest, simple interest. Sorry, you have to find out N. There is some misprint in this question. You have to find out N. So how to calculate? C. N is nothing but A upon P minus 1 upon I. A is what? 10,200. 10,200 divided by 10,000 minus 1 upon I. 12.5% means 0.125. See, 12.5% is nothing but 12.5 divided by 100, and that is nothing but 0.125. So do the calculation. 10,200 divided by 10,000 minus 1 divided by 0.125. So the answer is, there is some printing problem in this question. 10,200. Instead of that, it should be okay, whatever it is. 10,200 divided by 10,000. Let us do the calculation once again. 10,200 divided by 10,000 minus 1 and divide by 0.125. So 0.16, n equal to 0.16. These are in terms of years. So 0.16 into 12, if you multiply it by 12, so the answer is 1.92 months. Instead of year, now it becomes months, means approximately 2 months. That is the answer. But instead of 10,200, see, if we write, if we calculate this, one point six into point one two five plus one into ten thousand twelve thousand. Instead of this, if it is 12,000, there is correction here, but it's okay. If we write 10,200, it's okay. But sorry, if A equal to 12,000, then what I want to explain in this question, see, if A equal to 12,000, then N equal to 12,000 divided by P, that is 10,000 minus 1 upon I 0.125. So see what we get. 12,000 divided by 10,000 minus 1 divided by 0.125. So we get answer 1.6. Now listen, 1.6 years. That means what? Listen carefully. 1.6 years, that means 1 year plus 0.6 years. That means 1 year plus or and 0.6 into 12 months. So the answer is 1 year plus 0.6 into 12, that means 7.2. So it is 1 year and 7.2 months. You can write it is 1 year and 7 months approximately. 1 year plus 7 month plus 0.2 months. So it is 1 year, 7 months, and 0.2 months. And 6 days. That is the final answer. So your 1.6 years like this means 1 year, 7 months and 6 days is required to get that much interest or that much amount. Okay, next question number 8. A sum means amount required to earn monthly interest of 1200 rupees at 18% per annum. So you require monthly interest 1200. So yearly interest. Let us continue. So monthly interest is 1200. So yearly interest is 1200 into 12, that is 14,400. So interest is given 14,400. That is we require every year. And rate of interest is 18%. So use the formula. 14,400, that is the interest we require. P, that is we require to calculate. 18% is a rate of interest and that we require every year. So here we have to take n equal to 1 because every year we require that much interest. So P equal to 14,400 divided by 0.18. So let us do the calculation. 14,400 divided by 0.18. So 80,000, that is the required answer. Now you can solve question number 9, 10, these two questions by yourself. In next lecture, we will start with 11 and that is depends on what compound interest. So this is enough for today. If you have any question, you can ask your doubt.